Hello and welcome to the Island Circuit of Anglesey. We're here for a double header with the Fun Cup Championship. Coming up, the penultimate round of this year's series. But first, let's take a look at what happened in the first race here at Anglesey, one of the closest finishes we've ever had. And we've got the two leaders, two of the championship contenders, absolutely together here. This is Jeff Fawcett, Team Honeywell. He's already been in. This is a problem. He's got a puncture. That's going to put Team Honeywell well down the order. This is two drivers going absolutely head-to-head, toe-to-toe, having a real dogfight. And here comes Nigel Greensaw again. There's not really room for two cars here. Are they going to make it through? And Brandon Groot still leads the race. He's got, what, three more laps to try and hang on to this for their first win. And again, they're going to be side-by-side down through Corkscrew. Brandon Groot's got the inside line in the white and blue car. Nigel Greensaw's trying to go around the outside last time. This ended in contact. This time, he's through. So a dramatic victory for Race Logic, despite the fact that the car was looking rather second-hand by the end of the race.
Going up the hill, I was overtaking a back marker, and he saw me, but he thought I was going to lift off. I don't know why. And he said, I thought you were going to lift off. I said, lift off? We're trying to win the race. You're not going to lift off. And so we ended up having a big one, but luckily the car wasn't much slower after it, so we dodged a bullet there.
Standing to the left is Eugene O'Brien, boss of Team OBR. Amongst his squad is the 207 car, which is second in the championship. Regulars Graham Pattle and Mark Burton have been joined a number of times this season by 16-year-old Jordan Albert, who helped the team to third place in race one.
This weekend's gone really well so far. Yesterday was quite a good result for us in terms of, you know, points, but today I reckon we're looking for a win. You know, you've got to know what you're doing in this championship. You know, there's overtaking at all times. In terms of racing, you know, overtaking, you know, you can't beat this. You know, you're doing something at all times, you know. No, the car's great. You know, I love the team so much. Yeah, you can't beat it.
Another up-and-coming driver is Ollie Long, although dislodged brake pads put his team out of contention early in race one.
Yeah, I was going up the hill, pushing my foot on the brake, and there was nothing there. And then tried it again a few more times, still wasn't there, and then just had to pull off to the right of the track. Pretty scary. I was lucky I wasn't on the inside, to be fair.
A bit scary at the end of that straight with no brakes, isn't it?
Yeah, very scary. It was strange, actually, because in practice yesterday I felt it, and I didn't know what it was. And then last night I was running through my head, right, what are you going to do if this happens again? And so then when it did happen, this emotion went through my head, which is like I'd replayed it before, changed down gear, see what I could do. But yeah, it was all a bit rushed at the time.
Team Cat driver training are new to Fun Cup this year. In fact, they're completely new to racing, but they're improving rapidly.
We knew as a new team we needed to take advantage of any little thing that we could gain seconds from. So we actually practiced our pit stops before we started racing. We're not perfect. We have some good ones and we have some bad ones, but we are getting better. And if the boss will let me, the wife, and the budget can afford it, we'll certainly be here next year.
So let's take a look at the grid ahead of this three-hour race. On pole position, JPR Acura Scargo, Team OBR alongside Team Cat Driver Training and Team Everflux on row two. Nimbus Data and JPR Wacky Racers complete the top six. It's a random grid draw, but the team that won the previous race will have to start at the back, and that is the championship leading team of JPR Race Logic. On board with the pole position driver then, Will Pembroke, glancing across to his right, making sure they're all lined up. There is the black and yellow car, Acura Scargo. Get this race underway here at Anglesey as they thunder off towards the first corner. The left-hander on board with the pole position man. He's got the line, he's got the corner, and he's got the lead of the race. Coming towards the right-hander at the banking. Into second place goes Nimbus Data and Scott Kavanagh. In third place, Phil Marsh for Team Cat Driver Training. Then it's the Everflux car, then it's the 99 JPR Wacky Racers car. They're three abreast in the middle of the field there, trying to squeeze for position. That's CCS Media running wide just ahead. I think he got away with it. So you're on board with the second place car here, starting to pick up a toe already on the race leader as they come out through Church Corner, absolutely flat out and coming onto the back straight. And they're going to be side by side here. The inside line for this right-hand kink will be with the Nimbus car, but it's a left-hander coming up into Rocket. He's got through, though, before they hit the braking zone. And Scott Kavanagh goes into the lead of the race. It's almost a change for second as Phil Marsh has a look up the inside, but he can't find a way through. And thinks better of it. So down to second place now for Will Pembroke. The JPR Curious Cargo car there in second place. Team Cat Driver Training in third. Team Everflux in fourth place. JPR Wacky Racers in fifth position. No drama so far. They make their way down through the corkscrew for the first time in this race. Then downhill, turn left, then right. And they make their way through with a gap increasing now from first to second. A change just behind in the background as Jordan Albert picked up a place in the 207 Red Zeb car. The Team OBR car a little bit sideways here on board in second place, being whirled on by his teammate James Summerton at the end of the first lap. As into turn one at the start of lap number two comes the Nimbus Data car. There's the battle for second and third. Oh, and the Team TWM car comes into the pits already. A real shame after picking a good grid here. And here's the squabble in the middle of the pack. There's the number one car of Race Logic trying to pick up a place. It does so. Moves around the outside of Tim Wilden in the Honeywell car. That comes under attack now by the blue and white Global Racing car. And Eco Racing just ahead as well. So lots of the championship front runners in that little group of cars. Looking at the inside on the way into the left-hander at Rockets, picking up a place, moving ahead of the Everflux car. On board with Race Logic, trying to go around the outside of the Eco Racing car. Has the inside line now for the right-hander, the second part of the corner. Looking back from Race Logic's car, and he's got through. Picking up a place, moving ahead of Charlie Burt. There's a replay of CCS running wide, but look behind. The three cars there, the yellow, the blue, then the green and white cars, they all come together, and there's a sandwich, a squeeze, and the blue TWM car gets battered on both sides, and that, I think, is why it had to go into the pit. So it may have been a puncture, it may have been damage to the steering, as the Team OBR car has a spin, pointing in the wrong direction, and it's going to lose a ton of places. As you go on board with Race Logic, they'll move past. There's the Team Holden car moving past. Red Zeb as well, the 104 car. So it's going to be all the way down, about three quarters of the way down the field, as the race leader makes his way down through the corkscrew. Scott Kavanagh having a fantastic start to the race. On board with JPR Race Logic, making fantastic progress from the back of the grid. And look at the green and white Nightingale Racing car all the way around the outside of the number 22 Red Zeb car, which started on the front row and he's gone through. So fantastic driving there from Ollie Long to pick up a place. And back on board now with the Race Logic car, trying to get past the same car. Have to be patient on the way through Church Corner, though. Here's the tail end of the top four. In fact, this is the battle higher up the order with CCS coming into the fray, the orange red tape car. And he makes a move up the inside, around the outside goes the Nightingale Racing car. One, two, three places gained by Ollie Long. The green and white machine, absolutely fantastic move there around the corner, picking up a place here is Race Logic, trying to defend as well from the Global Racing car. It's all kicking off here in the early stages of this race. Sarah Reeder trying to find a way past, but couldn't quite do it in the Global car. So look at that green and white machine absolutely flying up the order, Ollie Long. And a problem very early in the race, in yesterday's race, the first of the doubleheader weekend here at Anglesey. And into that corner at Rocket, absolutely throwing caution to the wind, as there could be a place change here on the way into the final corner. They're on board with the number one car, the Race Logic machine, running side by side with the Team OBR car, just about picking up the place. Looking at Sarah Reeder, just back in the 188 Global Racing car. She follows through and gets up the inside. It's going to try and get past as well. There is the car which runs in second place then. Will Pembroke, JPR Curious Cargo. The team were going well in the first race of the weekend here at Anglesey until the car developed a problem late on. An engine mount cracked, but they looked like they had the pace to fight for a podium. Certainly a top four or top five finish, and they're going well here in second place. But look at Phil Marsh in his first season of racing, the team's first full season of racing. They started pretty well up the grid, but they're holding their own in third position here, doing a great job. Team Cat Driver Training. And then we've got this battle for fourth place here. We're going around the outside again. Ollie Long, he's got no fear at that corner. He almost went straight on there. He did go straight on there at the start of yesterday's race with a brake problem, but he's gone through, moving ahead of the JPR Everflux car, the black machine. So he's pulling away from the Race Logic car, which is also working its way up through the order. He's put three or four cars in between himself and the number one car over the last couple of laps when there were nose to tail. Speaking of which, on board with the Race Logic car, having a look at the inside of the 99 JPR Wacky Racers car, no way through, having to defend because just behind, this is the rear view, is still that Global Racing car, and they're making a move on CCS Media, which loses a couple of places here. So that's Jira Caronanti losing a couple of places on the way down through the corkscrew. And look at this battle developing. Look at the green and white car absolutely flying at the moment, already pulling away from the 103 Everflux car, which is coming under more and more pressure now from the Team McDonald's car, the yellow JPR rental car. Those two having a scrap, but being reeled in by that car with the onboard there, which has moved ahead of the 99 machine now, the Race Logic car. There is the race leader, Scott Kavanagh, who most seasons, most races for the Porsche Byfleet team, but he's joined Nimbus this weekend. I'm afraid TWM have got into the pits again, and that does not look good. It looks like they might be out of the race, I'm afraid. Here's this squabble then inside the top six, and there could be a change of position here. Launching one at the inside is the 110 car. Peter Cricks goes through. The Nigel Greensaw follows him through in the Race Logic car, and down two places then for the black 103 Everflux car coming out through the second part of Rocket. There's Ollie Long in the 220 car, the Nightingale car. And here's Nigel Greensaw patiently picking his way through onto the tail of Peter Cricks, who runs a little bit wide, gets out of shape, gives up the place, and back through, back ahead of him comes Race Logic down into the corkscrew. Just carried a bit too much speed into the corner. The CCS car still in the mix as well there, the blue and red car. Here's a replay. This is looking back from Race Logic, and CCS tried to follow him through. Anyway, both cars look like they've just about got away with it. Still having a fantastic squabble, and it's been a very lively start to the race. We're now heading for a break. Welcome back to Anglesey. It's round six of the Fun Cup Championship, and this is the battle for fourth place, with Nightingale Racing coming under pressure now from the blue number one car of Race Logic, and Nigel Greensaw has just squeezed up the inside there of Ollie Long to gain a place, and this is just ahead of them, the battle for second place with the black 88 car, JPR Acura Scargo, Will Pembroke coming under pressure from Phil Marsh. And they're being caught by the two behind, just behind them now. So we've got four of them battling over second place. Nimbus Data are miles out in front with Scott Kavanagh behind the wheel. A big slide there going down through the corkscrew. But he just about holds on to it. The JPR McDonald's car flies up the inside of the Global Racing car, picks up a place momentarily, but will lose the momentum coming out of the corner at Rocket. This is on board now with the 104 Team OBR car, and just ahead, the teammates to them, the white and red stripe car, making a little bit of contact with Eco Racing. Both cars are going to get past the Eco machine, and the Red Zeb car just ahead, 207, he's trying to make up places after an earlier spin into the pits with bodywork damage is the JPR Everflux car, which was running in fourth place early on in the race. And here then is the squabble for second place, and Phil Marsh is having a go at the inside and gets through on the way into Rocket, and just behind with the onboard camera, the Race Logic car is going to find a way past as well. Does he? Yes, just about squeezing through on the exit to Rocket. So second, third and fourth positions all change. Just behind them is Ollie Long in the Nightingale car in fifth place. So they make their way now out through Peel, and off goes the JPR McDonald's car. What a shame, a spin there when that car was running well up inside the top six or seven. There's another of the Team OBR cars, three cars out this weekend. That one started near the front of the race, but it's still going pretty well here, up in and around the top 10. As now, Nigel Greensaw attacks Phil Marsh. One's got hardly any race experience, the other's got years and years of race experience, and it's the one with more experience that's on the attack here, trying to go around the outside. Nigel Greensaw, vastly experienced sports car racer, up against a novice with Phil Marsh, really doing well here, holding his own. I think he might have to concede the position on the way into Peel. He does, and through then into second place. From the very back of the grid comes the JPR Race Logic car. There's Team Honeywell, Tim Wilden, who's joining the regular drivers, Neil Plimmer and Jeff Forsen, and he gets completely out of shape there. Skids on, did he get back on the track? I think he may have just about avoided a spin, but he'll lose a couple of places. We're going to our first round of pit stops. Team Holden making their driver change here and just checking the tyre pressures. No fuel going in on this first pit stop. There's James Summerton with the blue helmet, ready to get into the Acura Scargo car, which was running in second place earlier in the race. Team Holden go out. There's Bram de Groot focusing, getting ready to take over the race-leading car. Nimbus Data. Oh, big moment there for Phil Marsh, coming out through the flat-out right-hander at Church Corner. I don't know how he held on to that. He did somehow, and he's still got his place here. But the Nightingale car of Ollie Long has got the better momentum here. He's now got the inside line, and he pounces. Very rare to see Ollie going up the inside of people into that corner. He's been going around the outside of everybody today. Bram de Groot then in the Nimbus Data Racing car in this second stint. He's taken over from Scott Kavanagh, who did a terrific job for the team. There is Scott, just got out of the car. Brilliant job to lead the race by a long, long way as well. They were miles out in front, on board with James Summerton. This has become a battle for a podium position now. The 207 Team OBR car has come right back up through the order, making its way through the last turn and a spin there. Oh, damage to the right wheel. The right wheel was loose there, and that's why I think the car went into a spin in the first place. James Summerton is going to be stranded. He won't get that going again. Here's a replay on board with James, and it just snaps away from him. So a broken wheel or suspension at the rear of the car, sending one of the favourites for a podium out of contention, I'm afraid. So they're on their own now, the Team OBR car, and have a nice big gap, but still way down on the race leaders. They're in second place. This is the scoreboard for third between Race Logic and Nightingale Racing, which has both had driver changes. Team Honeywell are trying to fend off the Eco Racing car, which has now got Tom Mills behind the wheel, who's flying. That team had a very quick pit stop, which gained a lot of places for them. On board with Rob Thomas, 104 Team OBR, door opening up on the Everflux car. Oh, and a spin right across his bows. He almost made contact with the Ellen McDonald's car, but just about got away with it. While many of the teams racing here this weekend prepare, run and own their own cars, the grid is also filled with drivers who simply turn up with a suit, a helmet and a race licence and let the organisers take care of the rest, thanks to an established rental system.
We make it as easy as possible for people to get involved. So for a fixed price, you can come along and race. You don't have to go down the traditional way of actually buying and owning a car, sorting the team out to look after the car. You know, we will guide people through the license process. And again, you know, if you're just hiring a car, you can even hire a seat. So if you're what we call a lone driver, we'll make the team for you. You know, we'll find the other two drivers, put them all together, and they just hire the car. And we provide all the backup, the mechanics, the transport. When you're hiring a car, it's not like you're committed to such a lot of money. You can come and sample the racing.
You look into the buying a car or renting a car, and I think the huge benefit in renting a car, we can just turn up, jump in the car. We know the car's set up well. JPR have been renting the cars for a number of years. They know how to set the cars up. We just turn up and drive.
We literally turned up half past 10 on the track at 10:45. Doesn't get any better than that. The mechanics are just faultless. We've never had a mechanical breakdown. You can't beat 100%. Everybody here is so friendly as well. We go over and speak to Nigel, he gives us his data, and we all learn off the Race Logic stuff. And where else would you get that? It'd take you years and years and years experience to get anywhere close to what we've learned in half a season. You know, it's just a great place, I think. I think it's one of the best things to recruit people like myself. A novice coming in, it just suits me. It's great. I love the endurance, I love all the time you get and all that experience you get. And so, yeah, I'll be back.
During the middle phase of the race, some hard driving and brutal work in the pits enabled Team Honeywell to challenge for a podium despite an ill-handling car. CCS Media fell out of contention when the car came to rest in a precarious position, and Red Tape Racing had a car that was spitting flames and all too often in the pits. The racing became incredibly close as Team OBR, Nightingale, Race Logic and Eco shadowed each other, this move putting Nightingale up into the lead. It had become a battle for the lead because, unfortunately, Nimbus Data Racing were stuck in the pits with an engine drama that had been developing throughout the race. Their championship hopes over. Into the final stint then, the closing stages. The safety car recently bunched this lot up, so it destroyed the advantage that Graham Pattle had in the Team OBR car. The race leader now has been caught by Nigel Greensall, none other than Nigel, in the number one Race Logic car, just behind them a lap or so down, but battling for a top six place is the Global Racing car coming out through Church Corner then, on board with the second place car, picking up a tow. The Team OBR car has had a terrible misfire for the last half an hour or so, and it's down on power in a straight line, although it's still a relatively quick car. So this is the best opportunity for a change of lead to occur. And he's lined up the move here. Nigel Greensall's got up the inside, but very late on the brakes is Graham Pattle. These two have had some fantastic battles this year. And Graham's still got the inside line through Rocket. He's held on to the lead of the race here. Runs a little bit wide, though, coming out of the corner and on board with Race Logic. I think he's got through. This is looking back from the number one car. And yes, he's got the line, and he gets ahead of Graham Pattle, who just just about closing the door in time to stop the global machine unlapping itself. So they go back down through the corkscrew, but there's nothing between them in terms of lap times, and Graham might now benefit from a tow because the car is down on power in a straight line, but he'll pick up the tow from the new race leader, Race Logic. Just behind, there's an almighty scrap going on for third place as well between Team Honeywell and Eco Racing. Everybody in the top six or seven all together, and Graham Paddle, he's having a go at the inside into turn one. There's just a few laps to go. He's got his nose in front here. Graham Paddle going for the lead of the race, but Nigel Greensill's got the inside line for the right-hander. He's super late on the brakes, and he just about keeps Graham behind him. But again, Graham, he's going to be in a position as they come out through Church Corner to pick up a tow here. Look at that Global Racing car keeping tabs with them as well. Now, while all that was going on, this was going on just outside the battles for the podium positions. This was a great move from Simon Bonham to get up the inside of the Team Holden car. These two squabbling inside the top six, but then he ran deep and they were both overtaken by Ollie Long in the Nightingale Racing car. And Ollie has now joined this battle for third place. This is the scrabble for fourth place between Honeywell and between Nightingale. He's trying his luck around the outside again and again. He's done it so many times today. He goes around the outside to pick up a place. Oh, the Team Cat driver car. The driver nearly fell out then. The door wide open. Good job he's got a six-point harness on, but that team's still doing well inside the top 10. This is a replay with Simon Bonham for Team OBR, and that coming past is Sean Cooper in the 262 track focus car. It was unlapping itself, but that car going well inside the top 10. And here is the battle for third place, the final spot of the podium. Tom Mills looking across there in the number 61 Eco car. Up the inside of him comes Ollie Long, and he's gained a position. He's up to third place. He's never been on the podium before. He's a relative newcomer to racing. And look at this fantastic battle that we've got going on for third. Almost at the end of the race, we're onto the last lap then. So there's the leader. You saw the team for Team OBR, Eugene O'Brien and Marco willing their driver along to second place. Graham Paddle still won't give up. He's still within touching distance, or is he maybe no, just a little bit too far back coming into Church Corner, I think, to pick up a toe. The Red Zeb Team OBR car number 22 is just outside the top 10. The red tape racing car's gone back out as well, the orange machine, to take the checkered flag. On board with Simon Bonham, going past one of the back markers. And this is a ferocious scrap for third place, running out wide onto the grass with half a lap to go. He's the Nightingale car, and Tom Mills comes through. Eco Racing pick up third. The track focus car unlaps itself. So down to fourth place for the Nightingale car. And this is on board with Simon Bonham, who launches one at the inside of the Honeywell car and picks up a place. So he's going to move up into fifth position. Honeywell down to sixth place here with less than half a lap to go now. Less than that for this man. Nigel Greensill takes the checkered flag and wins here in Anglesey. Confirmation of the results then. A three-hour race, 2.8 seconds covered the top two. Eco dramatically through to third on the very last lap of the race. Nightingale just missing out on the podium. Team OBR and Team Honeywell complete the top six.
That's the first time I've done a finish in the Fun Cup. So I wasn't quite sure. You know, you get to the end of the race and you can't quite work out who's with you, who's in front, who's behind. Maybe there's a lap between you and cars. And so you just have to dig in and really go for it. And it's fantastic. Really, really good giggle.
Funny enough, we were handling quite nicely down through the corkscrew and I was getting a better run onto him onto the start-finish straight. And I had a couple of goes at him and I thought I had him. I must admit, the first attempt, but it was pretty close. And he's not the sort of bloke to seed very easily, is he? And I had to give in him.
Yeah, it was great dicing with Graham, as always. He's a brilliant driver. And I managed to sort of get alongside him going into the one hairpin. And of course, and then on the exit, he then ran wide for a very tight line, so I doubled back and got back up the inside of him into Peel, so caught him by surprise.
So two incredibly tight finishes here at Anglesey, but it's Team Race Logic who come out on top, and I think it's fair to say they've now got one hand on the championship trophy. But you never know what can happen in motorsport. We'll find out when we go to Cheshire and Alton Park for the eighth and final round of the Fun Cup Championship, and we'll see you there.